I'd like to take just a few minutes to introduce you to what's new in RC-WebView version 3.14. The team has worked extremely hard over the last few months to release three exciting new features for navigation groups. Number one, you can now view and control live data from all connected systems. Number two, you can now add HTML5 animations to show real, live systems across an entire enterprise. And if those two features weren't enough, we're thrilled to show you some new alarm-enabled animations, which brings an entirely new way to interact with backend alarms. Let's dive right in. Live data on a navigation group, I can click object here and head over to my systems and device 1000 and grab a value. Maybe I'll grab this building temperature set point and drag it to the patient comfort window. Notice that the live data automatically comes up. Maybe I want to modify this point a little bit. Maybe I don't like this. Maybe I'll choose this blue. That looks good. Click OK. Notice that the font changes blue. I can undo that change if I don't want to have it stay. I can head back into it. Maybe I want to change the display name a bit. Maybe I don't like building 01 temperature set point. I'll change it to building temperature set point. And I'll change that to display name. Once I click OK, notice that the name of the object changes. Of course, I can change the object value here by changing this to 19, and it saves successfully. We think the ability to grab data is a true game changer. We can't wait for you to try it out. Now moving along to the new HTML5 animations. The ability to upload new animations to the web server or to choose from previously uploaded animations, and by using that drag and drop to quickly add them to the canvas, unlocks an entirely new experience for creating amazing looking navigation groups. Let me show you how quick this can get done. To add an animation to a navigation group, I'll just click Add Animation, and I'll select a previously uploaded reliable controls animation. I'll grab this rooftop unit and drag this right into the canvas. Maybe I want to resize this object, so I can click here. Lock the aspect ratio, and notice that I can change my width and my height. I can also change the size of the animation by using the bars here. That looks good. Now I want to add an object, so I can just click on the objects, and maybe I want to find an object for my return fan, so I'll head to my values. This one looks good here, and drag it right into the linked object. Really quick and easy to do, and notice that we have a nice object spinning and animation for the fan. Lastly, we've introduced a method for animations to display alarm information from any or all connected systems. There has already been a vastly improved user experience with these animations. We can't wait to see how you configure and implement them in the future. To use an alarm-enabled animation, I can click here, click animation, and I'll go to my previously uploaded reliable controls animation and grab this flex tile alarms feed. I'll drag this into the canvas. Maybe I want to size this a little bit differently, so I'll just grab the bars here. That looks pretty good. And then now I want to grab some information and change this with the attributes tab. So I'll head down here. Maybe I want to grab the alarms just from my system number one. Now I can choose what type of alarm type I want to grab. Maybe alarm types 0 and 1. Maybe I want to grab different priorities. Maybe alarm priority 4 and 6. I can also change the system name or system device name. So I can show these. Notice how on the left-hand side, it's updating in real time. Maybe I don't want to use the word critical. Maybe I want to change this to urgent. I can change this label here in value 1 and notice that it changes on the side. As always, for the most up-to-date information on how to use these new tools, please check out the software user manual on our website and be sure to look at the help files for each animation. Thanks for taking a few minutes to let us show you these awesome new features. I'm Eric from Reliable Controls. Keep moving forward.